Recently, we have torn down many different types of chargers from different manufacturers. We know that our audience really wants to see the teardown of the Apple 96 Fast adapter. So here it is, our today's protagonist, Apple 96 Fast power adapter. We will see why this 96 Fast charger can sell for $79 without GAN, small size, PPS mode, and multi-protocol. You'll understand after this video. Let's go! Let's see the packaging firstly. This Apple 96 Watt charger comes from Apple's official website for $79. It's the standard power adapter for 16-inch MacBook Pro. We always let it to compare it with 100-watt chargers from other brands. The box style is just what Apple will do, simple and clear. Let's focus on the specification on the side. Model is A2166. It supports wired voltage input of 100 to 240 volts, an output of 20 volts 4.7 amp, 15 volts 3 amp, 9 volts 3 amp, and 5.2 volts 3 amp. Here is a label on the other side. Compatible with USB-C devices, recommended for 16-inch MacBook Pro. Then, let's open the box to see it. The box contains the charger, product manual, certification, and warranty card. Nothing special, just to look at the product. The charger is white and seems very clean, and looks like a standard rounded rectangle, just like the app icon in the iPhone. Corners are also rounded. An Apple logo is in the middle. We can see there is a white plastic inside the USB-C port, and at the same time, the receptacle of the USB-C port is also made of the same white plastic. In addition to ensuring the consistency of design, it can also reduce the wear and tear on the charger and improve the durability of the charger. As for the AC pins, it adopts foldable design and can be replaced at the same time. You only need to change the pins directly when traveling internationally, which is very convenient. This T-shaped base is not only used to fix the pin, but can be used to connect the cable with ground wire at the same time. And in this case, can it prevent the feeling of numbness when you touch the computer's metal case. The specification marked on the shell is the same as the label of packaging. After connecting the charger to the MacBook Pro, we can directly see the serial number of the charger use system information. If this serial number is different from the serial number on the shell, then you need to think about whether it's fake or not. In addition, the charger can also be tested by charger LED power Z MF001. You just need to plug it in, and the result will show up. Next, let's take a look at the size and weight. The size of the charger is 80mm, 80mm, and 28mm, and the weight is 294 grams. Use charger LED power Z KT002 to test the PDO message. It has 5 volts 3 amp, 9 volts 3 amp, 15 volts 3 amp, 20 volts 4.7 amp, 4 fixed PDOs, and doesn't have PPS mode. Okay, time's up, ready to tear it down. To be honest, after disassembling all those chargers, Apple's charger will be the hardest one. It's impossible to tear it down without the cutting machine. Even the cutting machine will take a long time to cut. If the cutter head is not strong enough, it might be destroyed. You can imagine how strong this charger shell is. We can see a large area of metal heatsink outside the PCB module after cutting the shell. There is a black insulating plastic plate in the middle, fixed by glue after removing the metal heatsink. Almost all the components inside are filled with black silicon in the gaps. This will not only make the components firmer, but also greatly improve the heat dissipation performance. The insulating plate and the metal heat sink are fixed by screws. There is heat sink inside and divided into two parts after removing the outer metal heat sink and insulation board. Next, we can continue to clean up the glue on the inside and outside after removing the screws and the heat sink. We need to be patient and do it slowly. The end of the USB-C port's plastic shell is fixed here and connect to the PCB through a flexible cable. Here is a fuse, protected by a heat shrinkable tube. Here is the safety X capacitor. Two common mode chokes are welded side by side to filter EMI. A yellow varistor is next to it. When the AC input is overvoltage, the fuse will blow to avoid the danger of electrolytic capacitor overvoltage. There are two black Y capacitors next to varistor. They have been fixed on the plastic plate by glue used for anti-interference. This is the power supply capacitor of the PWM master control chip. The specification is 47 microfarad, 35 volts from Rubicon. This one is the customized PWM master control chip marked with APSLCAOL. And this is electrolytic capacitor for high voltage filtering of the primary side. The specification is 82 microfarad, 450 volts from Nichicon. The primary bridge rectifier is sandwiched between metal heat sinks marked with LTKBP408G. There is a plastic insulating plate on the outside of the transformer, fixed by glue. Those two blue objects are filter capacitors. The differential mode inductor is in the middle. This cube is the PFC boost inductor. There is a diode next to the filter capacitor marked with L38B36B from ON Semiconductor. The USB PD particle chip comes from Cypress CYPD3135, which belongs to CCG3 series. It'll control the communication of USB PD particle. The serial number of the Apple charger is also burned internally. Here is the V-bus switch tube of output, which comes from ON Semiconductor NTMFS4C022N. Here are two solid filter capacitors for output, which come from Panasonic SEPF series. Both are 25 volts, 330 microfarad. Let's take a look at the back of the PCB. Here is the customized chip, comes from ST Microelectronics, 2460PF8N. And this is a synchronous rectifier controller, which also comes from ST Microelectronics. Here are two synchronous rectification moist tubes of the secondary side, which come from the well-known manufacturer Infineon. Model is BSC093N15NS5 and connected in parallel. This chip comes from Texas Instruments, used for current detection. Model is OPA333. And single operational amplifier is equipped, marked with BQY. The Dale 5 milliohm 4-wire resistor for protection detection is on the left, which detects the charger's output current. This is the PFC controller, which comes from ST Microelectronics, L6563S. It can boost the rectified and filtered DC and do the power factor correction. Here is a moist tube used for PFC boost. After seeing all components of Apple's 96 watts adapter, I have to say the materials are exquisite. Its capacitors have high quality, high reliability, and long life. Because they come from well-known suppliers such as Rubicon, Nichicon, and Panasonic. Besides that, the main internal chips also adopt the product from well-known international brands. As for the heat dissipation, a large amount of black silicon and metal heat sinks are used to help heat dissipation. It not only makes the components very solid, but also improved the heat dissipation performance. So, after seeing the teardown, do you think it's worth $79 or not? You can leave your comments below to talk about your opinion. By the way, if you think this video helped you, please double like and subscribe to us. See you soon!